Part 2. 25 bizarre phobias you might have and not even know. What did you think of the first half of this list? Did you notice any of the phobias with your loved ones? Or maybe even with yourself? Let's move on to the second half of the list. We're pretty sure you'd relate to the last one here. Keep watching. Number 13. Pantherophobia. This is the fear of one's mother-in-law. Panthera, which is part of the phobia's name, does not refer to a panther. Rather, it refers to a mother-in-law. The conflicts between a guy and his mother-in-law are commonly joked about. Pantherophobia, on the other hand, is no laughing matter for individuals who suffer from it. Vitricophobia, fear of your stepfather. Navercophobia, fear of your stepmother. And Saucerophobia, fear of your in-laws, are all similar phobias. Don't judge your husband if he appears to be terrified of your mother. This phobia is almost certainly inherited or acquired through watching someone else experience it on TV or in a movie. Number 12. Pogonophobia. This is the fear of beards. In Greek, pogon means beard and phobos means fear. Has your mother ever told you that unless he's Santa Claus, you should never trust a man with a beard or facial hair? Most villains in fairy tales even wear beards. It's one of the reasons why children who are afraid of them grow up to be pogonophobes. In 2013, BBC asked Newsnight host Jeremy Paxman to cut off his beard. The host then accused them of being pogonophobic. It caused a storm on Twitter. Number 11. Papathophobia. As the name implies, this is the fear of the Pope, or Papas in ancient Greek. It's a rare phobia that's linked to hierophobia, or a fear of priests, or holy things. Although many people wish to meet the Pope, all papathophobes must definitely avoid St. Peter's Square in the Vatican. Number 10. Trypophobia. This is the fear of clusters of holes. The name is derived from the Greek words trypa, which means hole, and phobos, which means fear. Thousands of people with this phobia are terrified of honeycombs, barnacles, corals, and newly blossomed lotus pods. They perceive danger in all the tiny holes. In the most recent season of American Horror Story Cult, trypophobia plays an essential part. Ally Mayfair Richards, the protagonist, is terrified by some holes in her souffle and a coral in her therapist's office. She has the illusion that they are staring at her. Number 9. Chirophobia. This is the fear of laughing in an uncomfortable situation. It comes from the Greek word chiro, which means to be pleased and joyful. This can happen at a funeral, for example, when your body tries to protect you by expressing happiness in a stressful situation. If you were frequently scolded for laughing in a similar situation as a child, you may develop this phobia. Number 8. Chronophobia. This is the fear of time, which came from the Greek word chronos. People who suffer from this phobia are unable to fully appreciate life because they are obsessed with the flow of time. We all know we can't halt it or turn back the clock. However, some of us find the whole concept unacceptable. Chronophobia is more common in older persons and among prisoners. They have different perspectives on time, yet it is tragic for both of them. Rip Van Winkle is the most famous of all chronophobic legends. He once took a nap and awakened 20 years later, having lost all of his friends and family. He conquered chronophobia by making new acquaintances and reminiscing old memories. Maybe it'll work in real life as well. Number 7. Philophobia. It is derived from the Greek words philos, which means loving, and phobos, which means fear. Philophobia prevents people from falling in love or having relationships. When they sense that they are starting to feel love, they want to leave as quickly as possible. They also avoid viewing romantic films, attending weddings, and visiting venues where lovers meet. It must be excruciating to live a life without love. Number 6. Deepnophobia. The majority of us look forward to eating out with our buddies. Deepnophobes do not. It's a phobia of dinner parties and is derived from the Greek words dipno, which means dinner, and phobos, which means fear. Several incidents in the past may have contributed to dipnophobia, like a horrible business dinner, a disastrous setup or blind date, or being forced to eat dinner with extremely obnoxious people around you. The internet has given way to plenty of other previously undiagnosed phobias surrounding technology and social media. Are you able to recognize any of them? Number 5. Punctumophobia. It's named after the Latin word punctum, which means point. It is the fear of receiving a message with only a period in the end. The lack of a smiley at the end of the message indicates that the conversation has become too serious or that the other person has responded too harshly. Number 4. Retorophobia. Retorophobia is the fear of misusing a word or failing to notice an autocorrect. It gets its name from the Latin word retoro, which means cross-reference. You should go over what you've written multiple times to make sure it's correct, or you can simply disable autocorrect. Number 3. Emoji phobia. This is the fear of being misinterpreted when using emoticons or stickers. Emojiphobes are afraid that the cat or a winking face they sent would be taken as something stupid. Number 2. Selfie phobia. This is the fear of taking ugly selfies. We get that. It's easy to go crazy trying to capture the perfect photo of oneself. Because people who take selfies don't sense any hazard surrounding them, it might even lead to tragic outcomes and mishaps. And lastly, number 1. Ignorophobia. This is the fear of a message being seen but unanswered. Many of us have probably experienced this. If the person we message does not respond, we believe we did something wrong. It'll most likely keep you up at night. Is it possible to overcome any of these fears? All types of therapy, controlled breathing, and visualization are popular treatments. Remember that it is much easier to deal with any problem if you clearly understand why and what specifically bothers you. Are you suffering from other unique phobias? Feel free to share it with us in the comments section and let us know what helped you overcome it. Let's help each other get past our fears. Feel free to share this video with your friends and subscribe to our channel. Remember, a simple what goes a long way.